got to. And that's a story that, you know, I've shared a few times and they asked me to share tonight. My mom is Phyllis Brennan. She had an accident in 1981 when she was working for Seattle City Light as an apprentice under our electrical construction worker, and had to have multiple surgeries in her knees. Hasn't walked well since, and it's sort of progressively gotten worse over time. I'm going to read a statement from her because I think that one of the things that I learned growing up with her, with a mom who had a disability, is that she didn't like everybody would talk for her and tell her what she needed or assume the things that she felt or wanted. At the time of the March 4th report, the big march, my mom could walk at most about 3 blocks. And she participated in a lot of other actions, obviously, because she wanted to be there. So this is my mom's words. What I remember most about that day was just that utter joy I felt when I found the bus for disabled people. I'm always anxious when I go to actions or events that I won't be able to get to where I need to go. I always go through a mental checklist and try to get as much information as I can before I go. How far will I have to drive? Is there parking? Will there be an elevator or stairs? How far is the parking from the action? Where does the action on March start and end? Is there going to be a rally? Should I plan to sit in a walker for a long time in a crowd where I can't get out, go to the bathroom, etc.? I wonder if there will be safety monitors with the armbands. I always hope there will be because they injure me if there's any danger. I fear fast crowd dispersal, you know, if there's tear gas or police forcing people to move quickly because I don't have very good balance and people running and bumping into me is dangerous. I remember when I got to the area where the march to the port was going to start. I kept asking people how far we would have to walk, and although I couldn't get a precise distance, I realized it was probably too far for me to walk on a walker. So by the time the march started, I had designed myself to sitting in the shade and waiting until it was all over and everyone came back and meeting up with my daughter. And then I remember it being a bus, but maybe it was a big van, and someone was helping me out the moment again. I felt sure it must be designated for specific people, not just for anybody receiving what they mean. Fortunately, I went over and asked. And the young woman said, of course I could get on, that was what the bus was for. That they were going to make as many runs as necessary for anyone who couldn't walk the distance, which did turn out to be quite a ways. It was definitely the best experience I've ever had at a demonstration or march in the 38 years that I have become increasingly disabled. It felt really good to be able to do as much as I could do that day. It felt really important to stand in solidarity with Palestinian people at that march, as I have for decades. I loved seeing all the different people in the march. Coming from where I live in the desert in Coachella Valley, it was great to see such a large and diverse group of people come together in a march. That was heartwarming to see. Old people, workers, young people, queer people, people of all different backgrounds. I want to give you all my gratitude in organizing that march. It was a precious experience for me. Viva Palestina.